previous video, we made a tutorial about Thanos snap effect and received quite a positive response. So in this video, we are going to stay with Thanos a little bit more and see how we made his portal with JavaScript from scratch. Let's check it out. In this tutorial, we are going to use 3JS library to help rendering the scene. First, let's download the latest version and include it to your page. Here is our example page. We don't need the CSS at all to make this happen, except the margin 0 and overflow hidden to hide the scroll bar. Let's set up our rendering scene with 3JS. The first thing you need is to create a scene. This is like a container for your 3D world. Next, let's set up the light. Without the light, you won't be able to see anything on the scene. Let's create an ambient light using directional light object. I'm going to set the light color to white with 50% intensity. Then, I'm going to set the light direction from front to back and add it to the scene. Now we have the light. Next, we need a camera to shoot your scene. Let's use perspective camera, which is the most common camera type for rendering a 3D scene. I'm going to use 80 degrees field of view and current viewport as aspect ratio. The last two numbers define the viewing frustum of the camera. Then I'm going to place the camera 1000 units to the front and add it to the scene. Next, we will set up a rendering engine. We're going to use WebGL for this tutorial. I will set the environment color to black and rendering size to our viewport. And add it to the page. Now the scene is ready, but if you render it now, you won't see anything. This is because we haven't added any object to the scene yet. Let's do it. I'm going to create a separate function called particle setup. Then create a texture loader object to load a smoke texture. You can use any transparent smoke image in PNG format. Here is the one I have for this tutorial. We can load the texture using load method. And when the load is completed, it will trigger callback function. To create 3D object, we need two things. First is geometry to define the shape. And second is material to define the surface appearance like transparency, reflectiveness, and texture. Let's create a plane geometry and material to put our texture on. Next, create a 3D object from our geometry and material. Then set the position and add it to the scene. If we try rendering it now, you will see our smoke particle. Now if you look at Thanos portal, you will see that it's a conical spiral shape. So we are going to create a loop to create a lot of smoke particles and place it along the spiral line. Here is the conical spiral equation that I Google and use it to set each particle position. I will also add a random rotation to create a diversity. Starting to look good. Now let's try animate it. To create an animation, we need a clock object to keep track of the time. Then I'm going to create an animate function. This function will be called recursively to animate our scene. And each execution will represent one frame. First, we will get the time pass between the frame from our clock object using get delta. We'll use it to control the movement of the objects in the scene during the animation. Then I'm going to create an array and add all the particles into it. And in the animate function, we will go through that array and add a rotation to it using delta. Then I'm going to render the scene and call request animation frame to start the recursive. Almost there. Now let's add some blue light to the portal. This time we will use a point light instead of directional and place it at the center of the vortex. Then add some random flickering using math.random. Finally, I'm going to add some background smoke using the same code, but we don't use the spiral equation this time. I will also set the opacity to 40% as well. And that's the final result. If you love this tutorial, don't forget to like or subscribe to stay tuned with us for more. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye!